Dr. Grimm, as I was saying, we laid on lunch for you before you set out into the park. Our gourmet chef, Alejandro.
What are they doing?
Oh. Feeding them.
Alejandro's prepared a delightful menu for us. Chili and sea bass, I believe. Shall we?
Should all be destroyed.
Ah, Robert Muldoon, my game warden from Kenya. Bit of an alarmist, I'm afraid, but knows more about raptors than anyone.
Tell me, what kind of metabolism do they have? What's their growth rate?
They're lethal at 8 months, and I do mean lethal. I've hunted most things that can hunt you, but the way these things move...
How fast for a biped?
Cheetah speed. 50, 60 miles per hour if they ever got out in the open. And they're astonishing jumpers.
Yes. So that's why we're taking extreme precautions. The viewing area.
Do they show intelligence? Here, with the brain cavity,
they show extreme intelligence. Even problem solving intelligence. Especially the big one. We bred 8 originally, but when she came in, she took over the pride and killed all but 2 of the others. That one. When she looks at you, you can see she's working things out. That's why we have to feed them like this. She had them all attacking the fences when the feeders came.
The fences are electrified, though, right?
That's right, but they never attacked the same place twice. They were testing the fences for weaknesses systematically. They remember.
Yes. Who's hungry?
Jungle river cruise or for a close-up look at our majestic...
None of these attractions are ready yet, of course, but the park will open with the basic tour you're about to take, and then other rides will come online 6 or 12 months after that. Absolutely spectacular design, spared no expense.
And we can charge anything we want, $2,000 a day, $10,000 a day, and people will pay it. And then there's the merchandise. I can personally...
Donald, this park was not built to cater only for the super rich. Everyone in the world has the right to enjoy these animals.
Sure, they will. I mean, what, we'll have a coupon day or something?
Yes. Gee, the lack of humility before nature that's being displayed here staggers me.
Well, thank you, Dr. Malcolm, but I think things are a little bit different than you and I had feared.
Yeah, I know. They're a lot worse.
Now, wait a second. Now, we haven't even seen the park.
Donald, let him talk. There's no reason. No, I want to hear every viewpoint. I really do.
Yeah, don't you see the danger, John, inherent in what you're doing here? Genetic power is the most awesome force the planet's ever seen, but you wield it like a kid that's found his dad's gun.
It's hardly appropriate to start hurling generalizations.
If I may, I'll tell you the problem with the scientific power that you're using here. It didn't require any discipline to attain it. You know, you read what others had done, and you took the next step. You didn't earn the knowledge for yourselves, so you don't take any responsibility for it. You stood on the shoulders of geniuses to accomplish something as fast as you could, and before you even knew what you had, you patented it and packaged it and slapped it on a plastic lunchbox, and now you're selling it. You want to sell it. Well,
I don't think you're giving us our due credit. Our scientists have done things which nobody's ever done before.
Yeah, but your scientists were so preoccupied with whether or not they could, they didn't stop to think if they should.
Condors. Condors are on the verge of extinction.
Oh,
if I was to create a flock of condors on this island, you wouldn't have anything to say.
No, hold on. This isn't some species that was obliterated by deforestation or the building of a dam. Dinosaurs had their shot, and nature selected them for extinction.
I simply don't understand this Luddite attitude, especially from a scientist.
How can we stand in the light of discovery and not act?
Oh, what's so great about discovery? It's a violent, penetrative act that scars what it explores. What you call discovery, I call the rape of the natural world.
Well, the question is, how can you know anything about an extinct ecosystem? And therefore, how could you ever assume that you can control it? You have plants in this building that are poisonous. You pick them because they look good. But these are aggressive living things that have no idea what century they're in, and they'll defend themselves violently if necessary.
Dr. Grant, if there's one person here who could appreciate what I'm trying to do...
The world has just changed so radically, and we're all running to catch up. I don't want to jump to any conclusions, but look. Dinosaurs and man, two species separated by 65 million years of evolution, have just been suddenly thrown back into the mix together. How can we possibly have the slightest idea what to expect?
I don't believe it. I don't believe it. You're meant to come down here and defend me against these characters, and the only one I've got on my side is the blood-sucking lawyer.
Thank you.
They're here. You four are going to have a spot of company out in the park. Spend a little time with our target audience.
Grandpa!
Kids! Get away!
Get we missed you. Thanks for the presents.
We love the presents.
It was
good
great. To see you. Did you enjoy the helicopter?
Yeah, it just went down, and then we all went right up.
Now, kids, come away. Not too close to the cars.
Aren't they lovely? Aren't they glorious, though?
These will be your transports for the afternoon.
No drivers.
No drivers. But they're electric. They run on this track in the middle of the roadway here. Totally non-polluting. Top of the line. Spared no expense.
It's an interactive CD-ROM. Not CD. You just touch the right part of the screen and it talks about whatever you want.
Lex, darling, you're all right in there. Dr. Sattler, come with me. Dr. Grant, come in the second car.
I'm going to ride with Dr. Sattler.
I read your book.
Well, it's great.
Do you really think that dinosaurs turned into birds? And that's where they all went?
Well, a few species may have evolved along those lines.
They sure don't look like birds to me. I heard that there was this meteor hit the Earth someplace down in Mexico and made this big crater.
Listen,
Tim.
Tim, which car were you planning on?
Whichever one you are. Then I heard about this thing in Omni, about this meteor making all this heat, and it made a bunch of diamond dust. And that changed the weather, and they died because of the weather. And then my teacher told me about this other book by a guy named Backer, and he said...
She said I should ride with you, because it'd be good for you.
The boat is now floating. Everyone must be on the dock for the 1900-hour departure.